Thanks for all the clubs.
Okay, hello. I'm Ambrose, and this is Sudarshan. And we're going to talk about two drones we actually built that uses the Intel Edison. First, who are we? We are Makerforce. These are the five of us. We are basically from the same school, and we work on what we do. We work on projects like these. This is a KSP, you know the game control space program. This control station for the game. So it's like literally a full-fledged control station. Yeah, we work on many other projects, including school projects. And so one of the first, we built a drone, and it's part of our project Waterforce. It's an autonomous drone that's designed as a race quad, and it's a standard X quad. So because we are using the Intel Edison, for the autonomous capabilities, we needed to design a custom PCB. So instead of going for like a single board, we actually chose to have a stackable design. So here we have the power board, and then we have a flight board, and then a main board. The main board connects to the Intel Edison here, and then the other boards are for power. The power one contains the power regulators, and the flight board will connect to a STM32 flight controller. The one we're using here is the SP Racing Evo F3. So they stack like that, and because of the pin headers there, we are going to use like the Arduino pin headers to stack these boards, and they can be basically modular by design. So if we need other sensors on it, we can basically build another board and then plug it straight in. And so yeah, they stack. So it gives us this stackable, expandable drone platform. Okay, on the next project, my friend.
So this is like a custom drone platform that we made. It's actually not a conventional drone, not a normal quadcopter. It's based on like what we call a dual copter. So it basically works on the principle of two coaxial motors and four flaps. And these flaps actually move to do thrust vectoring and redirect the air. That allows for this thing to fly. I'll actually show you a flight video later on. So this is actually intended for strong research, which is basically distributed robotics, and that allows for like robotics researchers to implement something that's implement onto a platform that's smaller and more easy and safe to use than a conventional drone. So actually what this whole thing runs on is what we call the HiveBot, and that's actually Intel Edison as well. And actually right now actually runs on an 80MB328 normal ML chip. And then that's just running the basic PID loop and the in-flight stabilization algorithm. So yeah, this is actually a new board that is now fabricating it right now, and actually uses the STM32. So that's 32-bit. It will reduce the loop time and make things more fancy. And actually, it also has a built-in power distribution system. So it basically regulates from the battery voltage straight to 5 volts, so I can power my servos to do the flaps. And this is just to make it easier for us to actually sell it as a hardware platform later on, so we have an all-in-one board that we can just give it, we can just sell it to them. So another picture, you can see that Intel Edison mounted on there. And so the main point of this is actually to reduce cost, because quadcopters have four motors, and that requires four motor drivers, and that becomes very expensive really if you are doing like swarm research, where you need a lot of drones. And this only has two motors, so two motor drivers, and that's basically half the cost. So this all costs around $100 to $150 to make, and that makes it very cheap and easy to implement as a swarm system. So here's a flying, just a video that's flying. Yeah, so again, my focus is quite bad, but it was very hard to keep it in one place. I'm not that scared of a pilot yet. But you can see the flux moving there, so right now it's in view. And yeah, it just does thrust vectoring, so it's really small. It's only like 10 cm diameter and like 15 cm high, so that makes it a really nice small platform to use. So we're actually be selling our boards on our website and maybe on Tindy later on. But yeah, you can keep in touch with us, or you can just come talk to us later if you want to know more about it. Yeah, thank you.